Alright, so I had to talk to my competitor. Definitely going to play first with this deck. We have a 2-drop and a skin render and a precursor golem, so not going to mulligan. Guessing it's Lewis Laskin if his name is his actual name, since it's Lou Laskin. I know it's a very tricky one. Oh, that's exactly when I want to draw my Vector S. Actually, it's fine, since I want to get the Blight Mamba down anyway. Let's see what he's got. I'm guessing a Glinthawk Idol, since we passed 36 of them. Goldmere. I will allow the block, which he will obviously not take, since it's pretty low EV for him. I mean, I guess he might. I just get to regenerate my guy. I assumed he wouldn't. Curve out here a little bit. Then we have a skin render. Get in for some poison, drop another guy, and hopefully a precursor golem. I don't know about this Vector Ass. I know he's like one of the worst poison guys, but I figured having one in our deck, it's not that bad. Kind of acts like a 2-drop when we don't have one. Seems better than like a withstand death, but I could be wrong. He probably feels on the back foot already and having a tank, which is one thing I do like about this deck, is you just put your opponent under so much pressure. It's pretty scary. Like here, I'm sure he would like something like a Chrome Steed or something. He's apparently double queuing it, though. He's in 2 drafts at once, so this might take a little bit longer, but give us a little extra commentary time, which is fine. Trigon of Rage is not very scary. Sunspear Shikari can be. I think, especially after drawing that Putrefax, I'm just going to skin render that guy and get in for some poison. He's already at 4 poison counters, which is a ton. Hopefully we'll just be able to putrefax him out. This Trigon of Rage should probably just never matter. Due to the fact that we have Precursor Golem, I am going to attack with Skin Render, though. That's a pretty good one. That's also a pretty good one, though. So, the play, I guess, is just Flesh Allergy, the Angel. Get in with both my guys. I'll trade with the Mamba. I guess I could just attack with Contagious Nim. It's probably smarter. Farewell, Skin Render. I don't really see a reason to trade my Blight Mamba away for a Mirror. So I'm just going to bash with this guy. If he wants to block, that's fine. If not, he's going up pretty high in poison. With Putrefax in hand, this should be a good thing for us. Curved out pretty well, despite never hitting a 5th land and starting with 4 in our opening hand. My goal is just to, one time during this draft, Precursor Golem plus, so if we just rip a land here, we just win. Land, one time. One time me. Get there one time. Alright. And that would be the game. That was a pretty sick hand. Don't try that at home, kids. The Blight Mamba and the Contagious Nim into Flesh and Skin Render into Flesh Allergy into Putrefax. It's a rare one. Doesn't happen very often. But we'll go to game 2. Our deck's pretty sweet, though, so it might happen more often than not. Wing Puncture is an option here. We saw an Angel, but I just don't think it's going to be better. I mean, it might be better than Vector Asp, I suppose. We have a Tumble Magnet and a Flesh Allergy, Skin Render. We just don't have a lot of things that are going to kill his 4-4 flyer, even if we do Wing Puncture it. He probably has some Glinthawks, though. He has blue, so he could bounce our thing in response. It's pretty sketchy. I think I'm just going to leave it as is. The only thing I might take out of Vector aspect if we go to Game 3 and see more Flyers. We did hate two Glint Hawks, though, so that's good. So we'll just see kind of what he has. We also took a Chrome Seed from him. That was surprising. We got a lot of artifacts from some good decks, so it's kind of good that we have such a good deck and we're able to take some stuff. But Game 3, I might take out this Vector Asp for Wing Puncture, but we'll just go into Game 2 as is and see how it goes.